Bless the Lord who forgives all our sins.
His mercy endures forever.
Please kneel. Page 267. Pray together. Most holy and merciful Father,
we confess to you and to one another and to all obedient saints in heaven and on earth that we have sinned by our own fault, in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone.
We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven.
Have mercy on us, Lord.
We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit.
Have mercy on us, Lord.
We confess to you, Lord, all our past unfaithfulness, the pride, hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives.
We confess to you, Lord,
our self-indulgent appetites and ways and our exploitation of other people.
We confess to you, Lord,
our anger at our own frustration and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves.
We confess to you, Lord,
our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts and our dishonesty in daily life and work.
We confess to you, Lord,
our negligence in prayer and worship and our failure to commend the faith that is in us.
We confess to you, Lord.
Accept our repentance, Lord, for the wrongs we have done, for our blindness to human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty.
Accept our repentance, Lord,
for all false judgments, for uncharitable thoughts toward our neighbors, and for our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us.
Accept our repentance, Lord,
for our waste and pollution of your creation and our lack of concern for those who come after us.
Accept our repentance, Lord.
Restore us, good Lord. Let your anger depart from us.
Let your anger hear us, your mercy.
Accomplish in us the work of your salvation,
that we may show forth your glory in the world.
By the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord,
bring us, all your saints, to the joy of
his resurrection. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desires not the death of sinners, but rather that they may turn from their wickedness and live, has given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardons and absolves all those who truly repent and with sincere hearts believe in his holy gospel. Therefore, we beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do on this day, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, whose blessed Son was led by the Spirit to be tempted by Satan, come quickly to help us who are assaulted by many temptations. And as you know the weakness of each of us, let each one find you mighty to save. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our first reading is from Genesis. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to till it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, "You may freely eat of every tree of the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it, you shall die." Now the serpent was more crafty than any other wild animal that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say, 'You shall not eat from any tree in the garden?'" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden. But God said, 'You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the middle of the garden, nor shall you touch it, or you shall die.'" But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven and whose sin is put away. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven and whose sin is put away. Happy are they to whom the Lord imputes no guilt and in whose spirit there is no guile. While I held my tongue, my bones withered away because of my groaning all day long. For your hand was heavy upon me day and night. My moisture was dried up as in the heat of summer. Then I acknowledged my sin to you and did not conceal my guilt. I said, "I will confess my transgressions to the Lord." Then you forgave me the guilt of my sin. Therefore, all the faithful make their prayers to you in time of trouble. When the great waters overflow, they shall not reach them. You are my hiding place. You preserve me from trouble. You surround me with shouts of deliverance. I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will guide you with my eye. Do not be like horse or mule, which have no understanding, who must be fitted with bit and bridle, or else they will not stay near you. Great are the tribulations of the wicked, but mercy embraces those who trust in the Lord. Be glad, you righteous, and rejoice in the Lord. Shout for joy, all who are true of heart. Happy are they whose transgressions are forgiven and whose sin is put away.
Our second reading is from Romans. Just as sin came into the world through one man, and death came through sin, and so death spread to all, because all have sinned. Sin was indeed in the world before the law, but sin is not reckoned when there is no law. Yet death exercised dominion from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sins were not like the transgression of Adam, who is a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if the many died through the one man's trespass, much more surely have the grace of God and the free gift in the grace of the one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for the many. And the free gift is not like the effect of the one man's sin. For the judgment following one trespass brought condemnation, but the free gift following many trespasses brings justification. If, because of the one man's trespass, death exercised dominion through that one, much more surely will those who receive the abundance of grace and the free gift of righteousness exercise dominion in life through the one man, Jesus Christ. Therefore, just as one man's trespass led to condemnation for all, so one man's act of righteousness leads to justification and life for all. For just as by the one man's disobedience the many were made sinners, so by the one man's obedience the many will be made righteous. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
After Jesus was baptized, he was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. He fasted 40 days and 40 nights, and afterwards he was famished. The tempter came and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread." But he answered, "It is written, one does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city and placed him on a pinnacle of the temple and saying to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and on their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone." Jesus said to him, "Again it is written, do not put the Lord your God to the test." Again the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. And he said to him, "All these I will give you, if you will fall down and worship me." Jesus said to him, "Away with you, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then the devil left him, and suddenly angels came and waited on him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Does anyone here love hunting? Oh, there's a few hands here. So if yes, then I should measure my words just in case I say something that is partially untrue. Hunters are supposed to be careful people, just in case the hunter becomes the hunted. They have to be self-aware at all times, and they have to constantly check their surroundings for safety should a dangerous predator be lurking in the vicinity of their blind spot. And I found this to be as accurate for Christian believers as well. We are the hunted. We have an adversary that attacks us like a predator. It is Satan, the devil, who is a malevolent spirit. Perhaps no one ever told you that the moment you connected with Jesus Christ, you became a target from our adversary. His job is to hunt us down and to derail us using temptations. Holy Scriptures teach us to fight the good fight of faith and defeat the enemy with spiritual weapon. We find in Ephesians 6, it says, "Put on the whole armor of God," they tell us. And our gospel message today is the on-the-job training for us. It is true, on one hand, that Jesus came to reveal to us the character of his Father in heaven, but also, very important, he reveals to us what a man should look like, a human should look like, or act like, as God intended at creation. So yes, there was a fall, and humans acted in a way that God never intended them to. But here, Jesus is providing a map, or a blueprint, if you like, of how humans should function in the midst of the adversary's attacks, showing us that how obedience to the Father actually saves us. Pay real attention, you might need today's tips to survive. Well, it began early with Eve, our very first female relative. She listened to what the serpent had to say. "You will surely not die." That was the first lie to be spoken. She saw that the tree was good and for food, and it was a delight to the eyes, and the tree was to be desired to make one wise. So before we start gaslighting Eve in our minds, I want to remind you that we go through this every day. It's the map of temptation. It happens to us all the time. Ever since that first lie, there has been countless of lies in the world. Won't you know what our response has been? We respond quickly like Adam and Eve did and fall into the hunter's trap. The number of examples is staggering. Who takes supplements? Do you take vitamins, supplements? Some of those businesses can actually exaggerate the health benefits. They tell you, oh, your life is gonna be like never before. It's like your life, you won't even understand. It will be great. This will be just what you need and you won't ever grow old. Everything is gonna be fine. Is that true? No. Tobacco companies too, they have downplayed harmful effects of cigarettes for decades. So before the government told them you have to put in that you are taking this but at your own risk because things will not be good for you. But before they used to say, smoke to your great content, there's absolutely no problem with that. And today we know that that's not true. This is not just an issue of false claims to deceive public trust, but also there are personal attacks and lies to our minds. You can never be holy. You are too terrible to be forgiven, too ugly to be with others. You don't matter. Nobody cares. Don't listen to the adversary. Be on your guard. Once you hear those things, be on your guard. Know that that's not from the Lord who created you. The adversary is crafty and knows how to mix truth and lies in such a way that they appear to make sense and make it so appealing to our senses. And our adversary's methods are simple. He uses our senses and our desires. And the list is long of victims who obeyed their destructive desires, their corrupted desires. Who remember Samson and Delilah? Who remember King David on the balcony looking at what he's not supposed to be looking at? Their strong yearning. And remember again, it's delightful to the eyes and also very great to be desired. Do you remember Esau and Jacob? He's famished and he's coming from hunting, and his brother is there with this plate of just good food. It smells good, it looks good. He couldn't stop himself until he sold his right of being a firstborn. That strong yearning that has not stopped, there's no stop. Just because your body's reclaiming it, you don't have to do it. But he went for it all the way. Our senses need to be subdued, need to be stopped. We ought to strongly resist the adversary. And as he prepares his traps, we should be ready to recognize these traps and dismantle them and defuse them. We need to do a good job of resisting during these 40 days of Lent. Now, in all seriousness, it scares me that we downplay the effects of sin in our lives. Sin is advertised everywhere as desirable and not harmful, and this couldn't be further from the truth. The effects of sin can be felt throughout generations. That's why Christian believers ought to be super vigilant and talk to each other. This is terrible. We need to be on our guard. Be careful when people tell you, well, it doesn't harm anyone. Does it really not? We are one big Christian community in the world. What I do affects you and affects billions of other Christians. Temptations are very real. Only one man was tempted, yet without sin, and that's Jesus Christ. And it means we all have fallen for this trap of the hunter. We are called to be holy as our God is holy. Jesus won this victory for us. Let us pray for each other. God will heal us and forgive us. Amen.
Our first collection is for outreach. Our faith. We believe in one God,
the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again, Lord, to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship.
Under his
Christ our Lord, who is tempted in every way as we are, yet did not sin. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to live no longer for ourselves alone, but for him who died for us and rose again. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn, proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might.
Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. In the highest.
Hosanna in the highest. In the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In the highest.
Hosanna in the highest, in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love that you have made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error, through that of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. And the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ, we prayed. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me."
After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father,
we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory.
And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ in his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Apostle St. Andrew, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, the author of our salvation. By him, with him, and in him, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we're bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Thank you.
graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now to his world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Fed by word and sacrament, Jesus Christ is in you. Jesus sets you free from the world, the flesh, the devil, from sin and death. Jesus gives you strength to overcome temptation and shalom peace. He gives you the blessings of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.